It's a nice day to code. Today I'm going to show you a system to reduce code like this to this. You've probably come across code like this before. There are a lot of reasons to simplify code that looks like this. We're using a generic example, but maybe you need to invalidate caching, or maybe this is legacy code that no one wants to touch. We can make this more performant by reducing branching, making it more readable and testable. Or you could just impress your friends with this cool new technique. Let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is ask our favorite AI if it knows how to reduce this. Of course, it has no idea, but it's very confident that this is the right answer. We'll test that later. To make our lives a little simpler, we're going to start by reassigning these logic operations into simple little variables. Now we'll replace all those logic operations with these little variables, and we're going to build out something called a truth table. Of course, you can keep all that logic in place. It's just going to make the next step a little cleaner. To build out the truth table, we need to follow the code along and map out every instance in which the return can be true. There are possibilities where we don't care what the output is. In this case, we're just going to mark them all as zero or false. Let's do one together. The first time that true happens, if we follow the if statements, is when A, B, C, and D are true. When D is not true, we return false. Or when C is not true, we return false. Let's fill out the rest of the table. Now our secret sauce happens. We convert our truth table into a Karnaugh map. Karnaugh maps have been used for decades to reduce complex logic into its most basic forms of AND and OR gates. In this case, we could just reduce it to AND and OR logic. For this video, I'm going to be using one of the many online calculators that will reduce Karnaugh maps for us. If you're really interested in how this works, I'll leave a link to a lecture about Karnaugh maps in the description below. For now, we're just going to take the output from the calculator and we're going to put it into our code. Now we have some code that's a little bit easier to read. It's way more performant because there's no branching. And now we can test it to see if it's functionally the same. And look at that, the same results. But our favorite AI just didn't quite get it. I hope you find this helpful. And for any questions, leave them in the comments.